only Thursday. I've had a very exhausting week. Capital very. I was in court yesterday from 8:15 to 3:25, and my case still got postponed. In 2010, my neighbor stole something from me, and they finally caught him December of 2014. And the first time we went to court, it was in February of 2015. So I figured, okay, I would be in good spirits if I stayed through the anguish of being in court all day. The attorney's like, oh, we can just get this done and over with. Even the mailman showed up for me to identify he's the one who signed it, blah, blah, blah. And listen, it was like a movie that I watched. He got up there in front of the judge and started talking about, oh, I have mental problems. My father used to make me drink toilet water. He abused me. I need mental health treatment. All of this stuff. What else did he say? Oh, I need new counsel. I don't like, he said it's nothing against the attorney that I have, but I want a different one. And the judge is, I wish I could be a judge. I mean, yesterday I saw literally the perks of being a judge, only if you use them right. Court's supposed to start at 9. Court didn't start until, I'll say maybe like 11 o'clock. Keep in mind, I've been there since 8:15, okay? This man kept coming in and out, in and out. He was like talking to different people, like who was a part of the court, things like that. And then when I found out he was actually the judge, it's like, are you kidding me? Like, he was just talking and fellowshipping, and what I found out was, as long as you're there, if court's supposed to start at 9, as long as you're there in your chambers by 9, you could start court when you want to, whether you feel like, oh, I have cases on my desk I want to read, and they don't need reading. It's just, you're just using that to kill time. You don't feel like doing any cases right now. Like, what is like, put on your signal light. There was relatively only maybe 6 or 7 cases, and it took him all day. And to make it so bad, I was the last case. I'm like, are you kidding me? He had 6 or 7 cases. Court was supposed to start at 9. It started at 11. And then he had the nerve to break for lunch at 12. Recess at 12 and come back at 1:30. I'm like, you didn't even do anything yet. Are you kidding me? The whole courtroom was ticked. And he's one of those individuals, he just likes to hear himself talk. He just kept going on. Oh my gosh, he's the worst. The worst. It's like, I'm sorry, I just had a moment. I was just thinking about how bad it was yesterday. But it was emotionally exhausting, emotionally draining. When they were talking about postponing it, and the two detectives looked at me because they knew I was ticked. Even when the judge recessed for court, I was like, I'm not staying. I'm going to work. You know. And then you just told me a day before that I had court. I was just, orders and operations is my specialty. It is. That's my thing. So, administration, when it's jacked up and, it's my own case, and I was trying to leave early yesterday. But I said, if the mailman came down for me, and he's willing to stay, why wouldn't I stay? But I don't know. I really, really don't know. system, the legal system. You gotta love the law, but it's so, oof, Jesus. People abuse their power. It's ridiculous. Really wish I could have been an attorney. It still really isn't too late. But your first year of law school, you're not allowed to work. Because the first year is supposed to be so intense. Like, come on. It's supposed to be so intense. Unless I went at night. But I can't go to school, night school, Monday through Friday from 6 to 10. I'll be exhausted. And I'll never see Jared. Because I'll be working during the day. And I'll never see him. I'm telling you, me and Jared was talking about, we've talked about this a lot of times. Sometime I'll have him, we've been watching like the House of Representative meetings and discussions and things like that, and different things that come on television. He'll say, Mom, you should do that. You'd be great at that. And I said, honey, it's the story of my life. I said, everything that I'm interested in doing, I can't do being a single parent. You know, even state rep things, because your job basically, besides, you know, trying to implement and pass bills and things like that and amend bills, you're like a community service liaison between the justice system and the people, but you're always out. Your job, literally, it's like you get paid to just show up at events in your district. Again, I never see Jared. He's used to being on campaign trails and things like that, but that was more so when he was smaller. And now it's like, he's into so many things. It'd be too much for him, literally. I don't know. Even now, it's like, Jesus. Just let me hit the lottery and just let me figure out what I want to do.